Hello, your Emily ma'am is back again today to take your English 2 class. I hope all of you have learnt the answers by now. The opposites, the make sentences, I hope you have done your homework. The question answers, the exercises, hope you have learnt. Those who haven't learned yet, please learn it. Okay? Please learn it and read the story again and again. Read the story. And don't forget to revise the previous lessons which I have already been done. Means your... what are the names? I forgot. Sorry. The Little Duckling. The Raindrops. We Love Our School. And The Mother Bird. Please write the three poems again and again. If you don't revise, you will forget. Okay? Then when the exams will come, you won't be able to write. So please learn the poems and write and read the stories. Okay? Now today I'm going to discuss the meanings and who said to whom of this chapter. Means, thank you, friend. So let's start. See, in this chapter, you people have come across many new words which you have not learned before. Those are like chase, trap, crawl, peck, gnaw, hunter. So, to make the story easier for you, I have written the meanings of these words. Please read it. It's very simple. The meanings are a bit long, but it will be easier for you to understand the chapter. That's the reason I have written the meanings for you and I'm going to send the meanings. Please learn them. Don't hurry. Go slow. There is enough time now. But you have to learn the meanings. Okay. So the first one is chase. In the story, the sentence was, the deer was being chased by the hunter. The deer was being chased by the hunter. This means what? Chase means what? Chase means to run after somebody in order to catch him. Here, the hunter was running behind the deer to catch him. This is the meaning of the word chase. Clear? The hunter was running behind the deer to catch the deer and to trap him. Right? So, the meaning of chase is to run after somebody in order to catch him. To run after somebody in order to catch him. Him or her, whatever it is. Next. Now, how many of you know the meaning of hunter? I'm sure most of you don't know the meaning. Now, the meaning of hunter is a person or animal, whoever it is, who hunt for food or for sport. Hunt what? They hunt what? They hunt other wild animals. Animal can hunt another wild animal for food. Like in most of the, in your National Geography Discovery channels, I think you people have seen a deer running. The deer is being chased by a tiger or lion. Right. In the same way that a person can also run after an animal, to kill him or to catch him for food. Okay. So the meaning of hunter is a person or animal. A person can also be a hunter, an animal can also be a hunter. a person or animal who runs after wild animals in order to catch them or kill them, either for food or for sport. Right? Next, trap. Trap means what? Trap means, in this story, you have read trapped here. Soon he saw the deer trapped in a net on the bank of a river. Who saw? The crow. The crow saw the deer trapped. That means the deer was caught in the net on the bank of a river. So what is the meaning of trap? Trap means to keep somebody in a dangerous place or a bad situation from which that person cannot escape. That means the deer was trapped in the net and he was unable to come out. This is the meaning here also I've given. To keep somebody in a dangerous place or a bad situation. Here it is a bad situation from which that person cannot escape. From which, that means the person or animal cannot come out. It will be difficult unless and until someone goes and free that person or animal. Okay. Next, crawl. Crawl, most of you should know the meaning. Crawl means what? To move slowly with your body on. Your body may be on the ground or close to the ground. For example, if this is the ground, your body may be on the ground or close to the ground. Or on your hands and knees. Close to the ground or on your hand and knees. You can use your hands and knees to move from one place to another. Like you people do when you were 1 or 2 years old. Means when you have started to move from one place to another. Ask your parents, all of you, that all of you have crawled when you haven't learned to stand on your feet. That time you people used to crawl from one place to another to do some mischief or whatever it is. Okay, next, peck. Now, what is peck? Peck, generally, it is used about a bird. Means what? The bird eat or bite something with its beak. When a bird eat or bite something with its beak, then we call it peck. Here, you see, the crow sat on the deer's head. When the deer pretended to be dead, then what happened? The crow sat on the deer's head, and gently pecked at it. That means gently, he was trying to eat or bite something with its beak. Right? Last one. Gnaw. G-N-A-W. Gnaw means what? To bite something many times with your back teeth. To bite something. It may be anything. Many times, a number of times with your back teeth. That means gnaw. G-N-A-W, gnaw. Here see, the mouse ran and gnawed at the ropes of the net. Here what happened? The mouse ran and gnawed at the ropes of the net. That means the mouse had bitten the net so that it could free the tortoise, I think. Tortoise. I forgot the story. Okay, next. Who said the following lines to whom? This is very important. Okay, who said the following lines to whom? If you don't read the story and again, you won't be able to answer the questions. See, the first one. Don't be afraid. Who said? The tortoise said to the deer. Next, I am safe now. Who said? The deer said to his Friends, we must do something quickly, the tortoise said to the crow and the mouse. Next, hunters never come so far into the forest. Who said? The tortoise said to the deer. The hunter will come and take him away. The tortoise said to the crow and the mouse. So the first one, don't be afraid. Who said? The tortoise said to the deer. Next one, I am safe now. If you read the story, you will be able to answer. The deer said to his friends, we must do something quickly. The tortoise said to the crow and the mouse. Hunters never come so far into the forest. Who said? The tortoise said to the deer. Last one, the hunter will come and take him away. Who said? The tortoise said to the crow and the mouse. Please, I'm requesting all of you to learn these things, okay? And something else also, I was thinking to say, you know, I don't remember now. It's okay. For now, you learn the opposites, do the make sentences, question answers, meanings, who said to whom. I'm going to send the snapshot of meanings, of the meanings and the who said to whom. Don't hurry, go slow. Again, I'm saying, okay, no need to hurry, but please learn. This is my earnest request to all of you. I know you people are tired of sitting back at home. I know, but we cannot help it. Please give some time for studies. Okay, we are going to meet in the next class again. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. Okay, enjoy learning. Thank you.